Everybody, it's Monica. I'm here with another project. I created a mixed media tag for Butterbee Scraps for her shop. So I'm gonna go ahead and share the tag with you. I'm not gonna show each product before the tag because they're all very visible and you'll be able to tell exactly what it is. And I'll also have the part number in the description box below so you know exactly what item I used. So here we go. It's been a while since I did a mixed media tag. So here is my tag, and I will bring it up so you guys can see it close up. Just go ahead and get a view of the tag. The tag measures 10 inches by 5. It is made out of medium weight chipboard. I went ahead and I gessoed the whole tag. Then I went to town layering a whole bunch of metal on the tag. So I did use some die cut pieces from my Cherry Lens gears die because I wanted different looking gears, and I only had the mixed gear pack that had two different gears in it. I do not have the small gears from Butterbee Scraps, so I just used the regular ones. So let's go ahead and get started. So real quick, for texture for the background, I used my Crafter's Workshop. Crafter's Workshop stencil is this one. Doesn't say the name. Oh, Mini Tiny Circles. I use this one. So before I get into the metal, I went and I sprayed the heck out of the tag with, first I did three, I sprayed it all with my Marion Smith Designs sprays that I have made. So this is one of my own recipes. I call it Stormy Sky. So I used this blue. Then I used another recipe that I made myself called Midnight Purple. So there's this one. And then the brown that is on the tag is actually a recipe from her recipe card. It's called Caramel. And it's darker than you would it normally would be. You can see it on the flowers, but it's also on the background. It's darker here because I sprayed it a couple of times, so really saturate it and darken up the color. So I did all that. Let's see. So after I sprayed it, actually no, I adhered all my crap down first. I'm like all over the place, so let's go over that. So here you have this big, gorgeous clock that you find in one of her clock charms where she has a whole bunch of different style, really big Tibetan style charm clock pieces. Then I have a whole bunch of gears in the background, as you can see, from her mixed gear set. You have them all around. I just did them for texture on the background. Then you have these watch mechanism parts, I think they're called. I'm not 100% sure. I know she has them in her Clocksmith charm collection, these small ones, but I believe she also has another set where you have small ones and big ones in one package of just the stuff. And if she does, I'll put both of them in the description box below. So we have one there and one down here. Then we have these bronze wings, as well as the Filigree Heart here. She carries all of those items in her store. Then another item from her store is this awesome Tibetan style bee. Then also all the bling that you see on the tag, I use SS20... SS16 and SS12, I believe, all over the tag. They're the amethyst color. She carries those in her shop as well. In the center of the smaller gears, I did use pointy back amethyst bling. She does not carry that in her store, but you could use just the regular SS10 flatbacks. I'm not sure if she carries it, but the SS12s is pretty close, so you could always use that type as well. Then we also have the eyelets, the bronze eyelets from our store. I have two in this corner, as well as two down here just for decorative element. I did have two right here, but I ended up covering it up, but you can see it on the back. Next, what you will see is this chain. Now, for the chain, she does have this in her shop, and it's awesome. It's nice and big, and I just looped it around so it could just dangle, just to add a little interest to the corner. Let's see. Then what I did was I added these flowers. At first, I wasn't sure I was going to add flowers, but then I decided to do it anyway. So these are the large gardenias from I Am Roses. Then we have some apple blossoms from Waldricka Crafts, and I colored these with my Shimmers Vibes in the eggnoggin. And I just sporadically put them on there. Then these filigree metal leaves are actually from my stash. I love these leaves, so I had to use them. Then let's see, we have these light bulbs here, and I got these in a rack. This one says create, and this one says adventure. So here is my tag. So what I did with this is, once I adhered all the metal down, I hadn't adhered this section here or the wings and the heart. I had adhered everything down. I gessoed it all. Then I went to town spraying with it. We have the blue spray up here in the corner. And then it's also blue in this region here, which is hard to tell because it's really covered up. Then we have the purple in this corner here, as well as in this one down here. And then you have the brown in this section, as well as here. And here is a mixture of brown and purple. So once I did that, once I sprayed everything down, I went over it, all of the metal pieces and anything in the background with my Inca Gold. I used two different ones. For most of the gears, I started out using brown gold. And I had it like that, and then I decided to do the heart. I wanted it to stand out, and it wasn't standing out with the brown gold versus, you know, against the wings. So I decided to go over it in the old gold. Since this was the only gold here, that's when I went in, and that's what drove me putting these yellow flowers here. So the brown flowers worked with everything, but the yellow was distracting me, so I decided to add more gold. The heart just wasn't enough for the tag to go with the flowers, so I went back over the tag on some of the different gears with just the gold. I covered up the brown gold and went with the old gold. And then I also rubbed it all around the tag and gave it a really messy look. And I went through some of the middle sections as well to draw out more of the gold. So the yellow from the flowers, as well as the gold from the heart, weren't the only things on the tag like that. So we have the gears here, this one here that I covered in the old gold, this one I went with the gears on the side. Now for this one, for the clock, I did lightly rub the brown gold over it. And then, so you see it in the recessed areas here on the face of the clock. And then I decided to go over just the highlighted areas for the gears and the numbers and the perimeter of the clock with the old gold. So you have all of the colors standing out. So yeah, so there is my tag. If you have any questions, please let me know. I will link all of the products in the description box below that I used for this tag. And for the back, I didn't do anything really fancy to it since it was just gessoed. And when you're spraying the front, it gets underneath the tag, it just gets saturated. So I just went and I sprayed it and made it all messy. And while it was still puddled up, I used my heat tool to give it that marbleized, runny look. So that is the back of the tag. And this is the front. So let's go ahead and just do close-up of the tag in the different areas. Just slowly so you can see it. And metal makes a really, really great background texture for anything that you're working on. So go ahead and check out a shop. Hope you like the tag. Let me know what you think in the comments below. Thanks so much for watching. Bye.